We never seen nothing. I never seen anything that was taken in for evidence. When they returned it, we didn't get any of that. We didn't see nothing.
Carolyn Short says family members have always pushed for more information, wanting to know what hard evidence investigators have and why her brother, his wife, and their daughter were targeted. We took their concerns to the FBI. The special agent in charge of the case asked that we hide his identity.
Why is there so much that you can't share? What about that is so helpful as far as the investigative side?
So the case is still active. If I could, I would like to work nothing but this case. You know, we just can't comment on what we've done in the investigation because it could affect it.
At least five special agents have taken over the case since the abduction and murders happened nearly two decades ago.
You have younger investigators that are motivated and they give it attention, and it provides a little fresh perspective, like newer ideas, technologies change. You know, investigators change.
But even as investigators change, they haven't announced any leads since these sketches were released in 2009. A flatbed truck said to be near the home in the early hours the day of the murder, and a man with a weathered complexion believed to be inside.
Those sketches were released so many years after. Was there a reason that they weren't brought up sooner?
There was a specific reason why that we released it at that point in time, and I can't go into detail why those sketches were released at that point in time.
Year after year, the sheriff's office and FBI call for anyone with information to come forward. But when I ask specifically what they need to know,
anybody who knew them in the community and knew of their comings and goings, in other words, their travelings around the area, specifically during that time frame.
The only change in approach came in 2015. The Henry County Sheriff's Office started asking Jennifer's classmates and friends to come forward.
There's a picture of her smiling with her parents, and like that's what I see when I, you know, when I think of her.
I found Caitlin Lane by flipping through the last yearbook Jennifer was in at Figsboro Elementary School. She says they were close, but she's never remembered anything unusual leading up to the summer of 2002. Deputies wanted to know if anybody had been watching Jennifer, wondering if she may have been the target of the crime, something Caitlin says she can't imagine.
She was a really sweet girl. So I just, like, you know, anytime I think about Jennifer, it's just like a sweet, happy, you know, kind person.
Raising a daughter of her own now.
She's all over the place. Into everything she can get into.
Caitlin says what happened to Jennifer has stayed with her.
I've just become a little more cautious of like my surroundings and stuff, a little more wary. I would be lucky for Kinley to grow up and to raise her the way Jennifer's parents raised her, and like for her to be the person that she was.
And because the sheriff's office, state police, and the FBI have never revealed a motive for the crime or released any new leads, friends and family are left in the dark.
I can't imagine why something like that would happen to people like that.